Very
interesting
and gripping book and title. Let's give a brief history lesson on the man who ended apartheid, or killed apartheid.
Dimitri Tsafendas was born in 1918 in Mozambique. His dad was Greek, his mom was Mozambican, and his dad was an anarchist, and the whole family was contained several revolutionaries who had fought during the Greek War of Independence against the Ottomans. So Tsafendas grew up and was heavily influenced by this environment because several of his relatives had fought against the Ottomans, and he was also influenced from his father, who was a very well-connected anarchist. Mm. Growing up, he became a communist, and he became very passionate for the independence of Mozambique. And in 1938, he participated in several anti-colonialist activities, which led to a creation of file on Tsafendas by PIDE, the Portuguese security police. And this file later led to Tsafendas being exiled from Mozambique. He was banned and he was not allowed to return to the country. Mm. And for the same reasons, he was actually later banned from entering South Africa. And once he left in 1942, he was not allowed to return until 1963. Mm. After he left, he traveled to several places around the world, and he spent most of his time in Portugal, where he was constantly harassed by the Portuguese because of his past activities. During the Greek Civil War, he fought with the Greek communists, and in the early 60s, while he was in London, he joined the British anti-apartheid movement. And he associated with several prominent anti-apartheid activists, including the ANC representative there, Tennyson Makiwane. He came back to South Africa in 1963, and 3 years later he assassinated Verwoed.
Under whose instruction?
Poorly by himself. It was his own idea to do it. Initially, he thought of kidnapping Verwoed and exchanging him with political prisoners who were held at the time. But he quickly realized that it would be impossible to do it by himself, as Tsafendas was also a member of the South African Communist Party in the 30s. So once he returned to South Africa, he tried to get in touch with some of his old comrades, but he realized that none of them was willing to do anything violent against apartheid. So once he realized that he was not going to get any help in order to do something violent against apartheid, he decided to do something himself.
Sure. And fast forward to today, we now have a different version of events. Tell us about that. Under the apartheid government, they said that he had a mental condition and
yes,
that was his sort of punishment. But we know now he was a very sane man.
Yes, he was absolutely sane. It's a very long story now to explain what happened in the trial and afterwards with a commission of inquiry. But Tsafendas was perfectly sane. He killed Verwoed simply because, as he said, he was disgusted with his racial policies. And he believed that a change of policy would take place sooner or later after he had killed him, because he thought that he considered Verwoed to be the brains behind apartheid. And he thought that by killing him, sooner or later, apartheid will collapse without him.
Why was it so important for you to do this?
I believe it was a major injustice towards Tsafendas, but also I thought that it is the historical record is incorrect, and I believe that history should be taught correctly and as it is. So once I found out all the evidence confirming that Tsafendas was perfectly sane, I thought that it was something like my duty to reveal the truth. That's why I submitted the report. No, it wasn't me, actually. Once I gathered all the evidence, I collaborated with 5 South African jurists, advocates George Bizos and Dumisa Ntsebeza, Professor John Dugard, Mr. Chris Gavinder, and Judge Zach Yacoub. So I got all the evidence, I gave them to them, they evaluated them, and I wrote a report based on this evidence. And the 5 jurists afterwards wrote a letter, they submitted it to the Minister of Justice, and they submitted it to him along with a USB which contained all the evidence. found about Tsafendas, which included about 12,000 pages of documents, thousands of newspaper articles, and all the interviews I conducted. And the five jurists asked the Minister of Justice, Advocate Masutha, to look at the evidence, to read at the report, and reevaluate the case.
Sure. Thank you.
Thank you
for joining us this morning, Harris.
Thank
he penned the book,
me.
The Man Who Killed Apartheid, The Life of Dimitri Tsafendas. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.